There is a lot of stress going around, not just psychological stress. It's economic stress, it's organizational stress. And what is actually happening is that we need to understand, first of all, ourselves. What is our mindset? What is our point of view? Do we feel that we are overwhelmed? Is it too much for us to bear? Do we want to change things? Do we trust our people? And if that the question is yes, then what do we do about it? What should be the leadership, if you like, roadmap for the future? Last year, what we saw a lot, and also this year, is a lot of discussion, a lot of management agendas around organizational structure. We feel that this is the right thing to do, but on the other hand, we feel that this is not enough. We feel that what has been underplayed significantly is the issue of leadership, of resilient, of strong, of smart leadership. And basically my premise today to you is going to be around three things. What we need in this new normalcy, as we call it, is we need to have more distributed leadership, more collaborative leadership. We need to have more inspirational and engaging leadership, which means that the old, if you like, the bossy, directive style has to be somehow redefined. And at the end, we will be speaking a lot, and this is exactly what I'm going to be speaking to you today, around the dominant leadership styles that we are actually adopting in Romania and how this compared with the Eastern Europe. And I will give you some further insights about also Western Europe. Does leadership matter? Absolutely. And as was said very nicely in the morning by Professor Evans, you always have the chance to sacrifice the long term for the short term. So leadership at the end, it's about creating successful, strong, profitable organization. And we have so many times through research, through, if you like, the experience, shown that leadership is the key driver for profitable performance. And actually what is happening is the leadership styles, as you see, they have a correlation with what we call organizational climate. I will be doing some definitions, and as I said, I would like to follow a fast pace, and then in the workshop, for all of those of you that would like to dwell deeper, I would be more than happy to take it to the next level. So basically, what we can say again from research, that engaged employees, probably you know that very well, they have at least 2.5 times the chance to meet their objectives compared with somebody who is disengaged. Organizational climates, they really have an impact on the actual performance of the bottom line, on the top line. What is extremely important is how do we define those leadership styles? Before I get to the definitional part, I would like to share with you just one picture. And now I'm appealing to your hearts and not your minds. If you would like to work with somebody, and if you have somebody on the right-hand side and somebody on the left-hand side or column, which one would be your preferred leader? And probably the answer is not that difficult yet, but what is more difficult is how do I really understand, how do I decode the DNA of a successful or transformational leader? What is it all about? Some definitions. Leadership styles. Basically, is how do I behave, how do I realize, and how much do I realize the potential of my people given specific contexts and specific business situations. The typology we'll be using is around six styles, and I will go very quickly just to have the story as a flow. The first style is what we call a directive. Basically, do it because you have to do it. I will not explain to you why. It has to be done, and it has to be done now. The second style is what we call visionary. It's not about being Martin Luther King, it's not about being charismatic, but it's about explaining what success really looks like and defining clearly what it means to me and why it is important. So not just the what, but also the why. Third style, what we call the affiliative style. People first, harmony. Let's be nice together. I will give you only positive feedback. Participative style. I want your ideas. Let's build the future together. Let's try to find consensus. Pay setting style. Very interesting. I will be the example. I will show the way. And actually, I will be the role model. And I really care, genuinely care about your long-term development. So in the arsenal, in the portfolio of a leader, we need to have all the styles. The question is, what style do we use and in what occasion?